Hello and welcome to eBible Fellowship's Scripture and Song program. The nature of this program is to take a closer look at one of the hymns that has been written to glorify God.
Our hymn today on Scripture and Song is More Love to Thee, O Christ. In a previous Scripture and Song program, we looked at the hymn, Thy Love to Me, O Christ, and the everlasting love that Christ has for His elect people. Today, we are going to consider the love that the elect have toward Christ. We are commanded to love God. For example, it says in Deuteronomy 6, verse 5, And thou shalt love Jehovah thy God with all thine heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy might. What is it to love God? In John 14, we are told, starting in verse 15, where Jesus says, If ye love me, keep my commandments. And then skipping down to John 14, verse 21, we read there, He that hath my commandments, and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him. So we see that loving God has altogether to do with being obedient to Him. Are we obedient of our own selves? No, it is the work of Christ. Love is a fruit of the Spirit, a result of the indwelling Spirit of God. Christ is the initiator of our love or obedience toward Him, as we find in 1 John 4, verse 17, which says, We love Him because He first loved us. The hymn goes on to say, Once earthly joy I craved, sought peace and rest. Now Thee alone I seek, give what is best. We have Jesus as our example, who was perfectly obedient to the law of God, and pleased not Himself, but was obedient unto death. We saw how the greatest love was Christ laying down His life for His friends. So we, as the children of God, seek not earthly joy, but lay down our lives as a living sacrifice in service to Him. Like it was said of Paul and Barnabas, we hazard our lives, or we give up our lives, for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, as God works within us to do so. Each stanza of More Love to Thee, O Christ, makes reference to prayer. We want to be praying that we will be more and more obedient to the Bible. Obedience to the law of God is everything. We can find many examples of this in the Bible. The serious consequences of failing to obey God, going back to the Garden of Eden. It is of supreme importance that we obey God in all that He commands us. How about at the time that we are now living, when God has brought the world under judgment? We are familiar with John 21, and how this is a picture of the time after the great catch of fish have been brought in, the time after the great tribulation has ended, and the beginning of the day of judgment. Three times Jesus asked Peter, who was a picture of the elect, Lovest thou me? And three times Jesus tells him to feed my sheep or to feed my lambs. Three times, pointing to God's purpose for our day, to feed His sheep. This is what God would have us to do, to show forth our love or obedience unto Him in our present time. Father, help us to love Thee more and more, to be more obedient unto Thy word, and help us to feed Thy sheep. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now let's listen to the hymn, More Love to Thee, O Christ.
More love to Thee.
You've been listening to eBible Fellowship's Scripture and Song program. If you enjoy listening to our programming, we'd like to hear from you. Write to us at eBibleFellowship@juno.com.